हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। माई सेल्फ मुकुल बरवंत, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, संजीवनी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स साइंस कॉलेज, कोपरगाव। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द यूनिट नंबर 2, दैट आर द बायोटिक एंड द अबायोटिक फैक्टर्स। लेट्स वी हैव नो द व्हाट इज इन बाय बायोटिक फैक्टर्स और द अबायोटिक फैक्टर्स। बायोटिक फैक्टर्स इंडिकेट दैट ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स आर इंक्लूडेड। दैट मे बी अ प्लांट्स, दैट मे बी एनिमल्स, दैट फंगस, माइक्रोब्स, एनी थिंग्स विच आर द लिविंग, वी आर कंसिडर एज अ बायोटिक फैक्टर्स। एंड दे आर द नंबर ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स इन दिस स्लाइड। वी कैन सी द फर्स्ट स्लाइड, देर आर द एग्जाम्पल गिवन इन द प्लांट, देन फंगस, देन एनिमल्स, दैट आर ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म। इन इकोसिस्टम देर आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट रोल्स ऑफ अ बायोटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड अनादर इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट दैट इज अ बायोटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म। Abiotic, that means a non-living things, any things which are the not living, that may be a soil, that may be a air, that may be a sunlight, any things that we do not live, we consider as a abiotic factors. That two factors are important in the ecosystem. Let's see, environment, it is made up of only two things, biotic and the abiotic things. That may be animals, plants, living or the not living. In figure we can see that may fire, sunlight, soil, that are all are the non-living things. Let's see which are the biotic factors. Wild plant and the animals. Why it is considered as a biotic? We all know that there are the number of plants present in our earth surface. There are the two types of cultivation can be done. First one, there is known as a wild plant, and second one, there is a domestication plant. Wild plant, it is a type of plant which grow in the outside of our society. That may be in forest, there are the number of plant are present. That is uses for the number of applications. That is considered as a wild. And what about domestication? Domestication beside our society. Our peripheral region, we are growing some plants for the commercial or the economic purpose. That is known as domesticated plants. Let's say wildlife. Wildlife, it may be plants or the animals or fungus, bacteria or the anything live in outside of our human society. That is considered as a wildlife. Plants and animals form of the core of what come to the mind. We think about the environment. Plants are the fabrics which cover the soil. Okay, if you consider our earth, it is a one network, and that network, it is started because the plants or the animals. If we cannot imagine environment or the nature without plants and animals, it is a work like a fabrics. We know the cotton. Cotton is any cloth. Cloth is made up of any type of fabrics. And that cloth, it is beautiful when the fabrics, it is very useful. If fabric is not strong, then that cloth, it is not be strong. Let's see. They hold the soil, reduce the erosion, improve the water quality, plant provide our food materials for the shelter, fuel to warm, replenish the air, breath, plants provide the food for animals and the habitat for the wildlife. Healthy population of a plant and animal critical for a life. Invasive plants and the pest can run the crop field and forest and the domain and drastically alter the natural processes of a ecosystem. I have told earlier what is the use of plant. That may be a wild, that may be a domesticated. Each and every plant having the most important uses: food, shelter, cloth, and the which are the basic need of human, that become satisfied with the help of plants or animals. That may be a domesticated or that may be a wildlife. Wildlife, plants and animals. Wildlife, plant and animals are the population of experience their full life cycle without human interference. That means without human interference, they complete their life cycles. दिस पॉप्युलेशन आर नर्चर बाय ह्यूमन बट नॉट अ नॉर्मली ब्रेड अंडर द ह्यूमन कंट्रोल्स. दैट पॉप्युलेशन आर नर्चर, दैट मीन्स दैट प्रोवाइड सम बेनिफिट्स टू द ह्यूमन बट दैट आर नॉट कंट्रोल इन द ह्यूमन हैंड्स बिकॉज इट ह्यूमन प्रेजेंस दे ऑल्सो ग्रो. इफ ह्यूमन कुड नॉट प्रोवाइड देम न्यूट्रिशन वॉटर दे ऑल्सो कैन बी अ ग्रो. They remains as a group of essential, indistinguishable in appearance and the behavior from the other plants and animals. When most of people hear the term of endangered species, they think manatees, grazies, bears, whales and the other charismatic species. If these animals don't live in our area, you might think there are the nothing you can do the help. However, more than 1,300 species of plants, birds, fish, invertebrate and the mammal are listed endangered, threatened. Some play critical role protecting our country of wildlife and the plants. That are the some characters or the some species of that plant or the animals that having the wildlife condition. Wildlife, why it is called as a wildlife? Because they are not a need of a human for their growth and development. And some of them due to hunting, human activity like hunting, deforestations, number of species are the reduces. That may be a species can be a converted or the calculated like a critical species, endangered species, rare species. Endangered, that means that are the on the way of destroying. Rare, that means they are present very rarely. And the number of terms are given for that wildlife. So it is act as a biotic resources. We know about the forest. What is the forest? Forest, it is a group of plants. Group of plants or the animals live in a specific area for their living habitat. They have made structures. That group of plants or the group of animals is considered as a forest. And the both are the living together. Such structure is known as a forest. Plants, animals, microbes, bacteria, all things are present in that area or the structure that is known as a forest. Forest is an important natural resource for the globe or the entire world. That from the forest, such part of a globe where the factors of a plant growth have been ideal for the several centuries. For this reason, they are mostly found the region with a high rainfall region altitude and the usefulness of forest. They spread the commercial exploitation of forest for the timber and the other product, maintenance of bird and the wildlife, maintain ecological balance, prevention of soil erosions. That are the importance of forest. And it is an area where the rain is too much. There are the different parts of world have a evergreen forest. That means the evergreen forest, all season they are growing in nature, or the all season they have a grow. That is known as the evergreen. That are present on the equatorial belt in the parts of tropic. Then deciduous forest, it is present in parts of a tropic and the temperate region. Then coniferous forest, that present in temperate and the arctic region. Then scrub forest, they presented in dry region. Each of one them are a different respect composition of species, atmospheric feature, its location, density of plants and the type of wildlife has the harbor. Forest resources are the most important resources of our country. Useful and maintaining the ecological balance, providing the firewood, providing the raw material to many industries, providing the protection to wild animals and conserves to the soil. That are the importance of a forest. Let's see which are the types of forest. Deciduous, evergreen, coniferous and the scrub forest. The trees shed their leaves during the winter and they grow in freshly during the summer. That is known as deciduous forest. They remain green throughout the year. In all season they have a green. Then coniferous forest typically grow in a cold and hilly like Himalaya region and with a coniferous plant. Then scrub forest with a parched vegetation, poor growth in plant and such type of forest spread over the dry parts of our country. That is known as a scrub forest. Okay, this is about the forest and the wildlife. Then next biotic factor, that are the grassland. It is one type of a biotic factor. The name indicate their concept. Grass, we know the grass, that means a number of grasses are present in the country. But in some swampy area where are the rainy season too much, like Western Ghats and the near the forest region, they are the producing the too much grass. So the grassland, it is a work as a one type of a biotic factors. The world grassland encompass wide variety of climate, vegetation, animal life. While the all grassland and vast open space react to little the 10 to 13 inches of rain per year, the region of a grassland slightly different. Grassland are the areas where the vegetation is dominated by grasses and the other herbaceous plant. Grassland are found in all continent except the Antarctica. That is the one most ecoregion of the earth. Grassland vegetation can vary height to height. Grow plants, grasses grows in the great concentration climate where the annual rainfall is 250 to the 900 mm. Mostly wild plant are observed in grasses. I have seen firstly or the tale firstly about the grassland. Grassland are occur in the area of a forest, and in the forest there are the number of wild plant are present. So that is in grassland number of wild plant are present. Grassland are the vital importance raising the livestock for the human consumption. For a milk, in a grassland wild plant sedges, rushes, herbs are mostly present. Area of mites, insect, larvae, nematode, earthworms inhabit to deep soil in the grassland. The area of variety of mammal, reptiles, birds, insect also present in it. Mammals are the blue and the beast, American bison, giant anteater occurring in the grassland region. That are the plants and animals occur in that type of vegetation. There are the different types of grasses, tall grasses, mid grasses and the short grasses. Which are the tall grasses? The height of grasses, it is more than 5 to 8 feet. Such type of grasses like Indian grasses, switch grasses and the big blue stem grasses. Then mid grasses, which having a height of 2 to 4 feet. That are the species included like needle grasses, western wheat grasses, tun grasses, Indian rice grasses. That is known as the mid grasses. Mid grasses example and their height. Then short grasses, which having the height up to the 1.5 feet. For example, buffalo grasses, blue grasses and the some important species. Then plankton as a biotic resource. What is plankton? Plankton, it is any type of structures that present in a soil. That present in an ocean. That is considered as a plankton or the aquatic sources. That may be plants or the animals. If plants is known as phytoplankton and animal is known as the zooplankton. The planktons are the marine or the freshwater organism. Because they are non-motile, so too small and the weak to swim to against the current flow, they exist drifting stage. The term plankton is collectively name of all such organisms that include certain algae, bacteria, protozoa, crustacean, mollusks, cylindrotrate, as well as a representative forms of all every other phylums of animals and the plants. The planktons are productive base of both marine and the freshwater ecosystem. They providing the food for the larger animals and indirectly for the human, whose fishery depends upon the planktons as a human. The resources of plankton is only begun the develop and the exploited in the view of its high biological productivity and the wide excellent. It has been demonstrated on the several occasion of that large scale culture of algae technically feasible. I have explained previously, plankton collectively considered as those organisms living in a fresh or the marine water. That is considered as a plankton. That may be plants, animals, bacteria, microbes, fungus, anything which are living in. And that are present in the condition of sometimes that attaches to the substratum and they are grow current flow with water. And sometimes if they are the weak, so they flow with the water of water flow. Okay, that are the characteristics of a planktons. Let's see phytoplanktons. I have previously explained phytoplanktons means, the plants which grow in the water, or the planktons in the form of a plants, that is known as a phytoplanktons. The plant like community of plankton is called as phytoplanktons, and animal like community is known as a zooplankton. This is a convenient division, is without fault, for the strictly speaking the many planktonic organism are neither clearly plant or nor animal, but rather is better to describe the protist. When the size is a usual criteria of plankton, can be subdivided into macroplankton and the microplankton. Macroplankton, that means a large size, and micro, that means a very small size. Then nanoplankton, through no sharp line can be drawn between these categories. Microplankton can be collected with the coarse net, or the morphological details of individual organism easily discernible. This form is a 1 mm or the more in the length, ordinarily do not include phytoplanktons. The microplanktons and the compose of organism between the 0.005 to the 1 mm in the size, and the zip component of marine phytoplankton founds the algal groups include the diatoms, dinoflagellates, coccolithophorids, silicoflagellates, cryptomonads, and the green algae are the found in the most plankton samples. Freshwater phytoplanktons usually rich in a green algae also include the diatoms, blue green algae, and true flagellates. Then zooplanktons. What is meant by zooplanktons? It divided in two groups, temporary planktons and the permanent planktons. Temporary planktons included the planktonic egg and the larvae members, benthos, nectons, and the permanent planktons include the animals live with the complete life cycle with the floating stage. There are the two types of zooplankton. First, it is a temporary, and this another one is a permanent. Permanent, that are the float on water, and the temporary, that means egg, larvae, that are present in a for the short period in the such waters. Then representative form of a nearly evenly phylum animal kingdom found in the permanent planktons. Among the protozoa, the planktonic for the amniferians and the radiolarians are the abundant, widespread in their skeleton of constituent, the bulk of a bottom sediment over the wide ocean areas. They are absent in a fresh water. The ciliate protozoa are the representative mainly by titanates, which are between the 20 to 640 micron size, and the size of sometimes occur vast in number. Among the planktonic cylindrate are the beautifuls and the siphonophores, and the jellyfishes are included such type of a zooplankton. Next, bacteria and fungi. In the oceans, there is not only include the or the in biotic factor not include plants and animals. Sometimes it includes the bacteria and fungi. It is also known as the living. Bacteria and fungi is a found in, belongs to the definition of a plankton, but because of special techniques required for the sampling identification, they usually consider separately. That is actually considered in the phytoplankton, zooplankton, but their structure and identification technique is different. So they are collecting sample techniques also is different. These organisms are important in the transformation of dead organic material into the inorganic nutrient. Some of these marine freshwater microorganisms fix the molecular nitrogen from water containing diazole, air forming the ammonia or the related nutrient important for the phytoplankton growth. Although the bacteria and the fungi always are found in water samples, peculiar situation exists in the Black Sea, where the water is below 130 to 180 meter that contain hydrogen sulfide and the no oxygen. Under this condition, only bacteria are the formed. That means a very 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 low quality of water, that means garbage water, that also possess the bacteria and fungi. So there are organic matter are available for the growing that fungus or the bacteria. Next, plankton and biological productivity. The productivity of an area is depends on the current and the availability of a nutrient. Current that flow the near continent are the important for the plankton production in an area. In that sea, the adequate supply of nutrient include carbon dioxide unable to phytoplanktons and the benthic algae to transform the light energy of a sun into the energy rich chemicals component through a photosynthesis, and the bottom dwelling algae are the responsible for about 2% of a primary production of the oceans, and the remaining 98% attribute for the phytoplanktons. Then biogeochemical cycle significance. What are the significance of that biogeochemical cycle? First, there is food chain. Aside from the representing bottom, few level of food chain are the support commercially important fishery. Plankton ecosystem play role in a biogeochemical cycle, and the many important chemicals including the ocean carbon cycle, primarily grazing the phytoplankton, zooplankton provide the carbon, and the planktic food web either the respiring it to the provide the metabolic energy, or upon the death of a biomass or the detritus, the organic material tends to be denser than the seawater, and as a result it sink into the bottom open ocean ecosystem away from the coastline, and the transporting carbon along with it. These processes is known as a biological pump, and one of the reason of ocean constitute largest carbon sink of the earth. That is a cycles that run, and what are the important of that cycle to the ecosystem. We all know the uses of carbon, uses of oxygen to animals as well as plants. The phytoplankton absorbs the energy from sun, nutrient from the water, produces their own food by the process of photosynthesis. The phytoplankton releases the molecular oxygen into the water, and it is estimated 50-85% of world oxygen produced by the phytoplankton. The photosynthesis. The rest of produced via photosynthesis land plant by atmospheric CO2. Then biomass variability. Sometimes they show the variability in a biomass. Which type of variable content? That means a variation. The growth of phytoplankton population is dependent light level and the nutrient level availability. Because light level and the nutrient level at all condition or in the all the sea, it is not same, so there is a variability of biomass will be occur. If some plant giving the more sunlight, they grow, they prepare more food, so they grow more. And if any plant they do not get a proper sunlight, so they do not grow properly. The chief factor of limiting growth of varies from the region to region world oceans. On the broad scale of growth phytoplankton, the oligotrophic and subtropical gyres generally limited nutrient supply while light often limit phytoplankton growth in the subarctic gyres. Environmental variability, phytoplankton and these organism forms the base of the marine food web. This variability of phytoplankton growth influence the tropic level. Then plant domestication. What is mean by plant domestication? Some plant are the domesticated, that is a habitual to the human welfare. Human use, they are cultivated for own use. The plantation of trees of human care refer as the domestication plant, because human taking a care or the growth and development of the plants in the hand of human, so that is known as the domestication of a plant. The plant domestication is primarily do that a different purpose, for the economy, for the aesthetic purpose, for the enjoyment, or the enhanced beauty of house. For the different purpose human are cultivating the plants, so that plant is known as a domestication. That may be agriculture crop plant, that may be some fruit crops, vegetable crops are the growing by human, that all are considered as a domesticated plant. Mostly domestication plant are selected on general wise desirable characters. Human cannot cultivate any plant beside or the caring that plant outside the farm. They are choosing the desirable character. They do not cultivate the Parthenium. They cultivate the wheat plant, maize plant, because they are desirable characters. And it includes, and such desirable characters includes like high germination rate, more predictable synchronous germination, increase the size of a reproductive organ, reduce the physical and chemical defense, changes the biomass allocation, more fruit, more root. Then agriculture. What is my agriculture? Agriculture, it is any type of cultivation of a plant with a beneficial. That may be a tomato, that may be a wheat, maize, any plant that are cultivated in a large quantity, that is considered as agriculture. Agriculture is the cultivation and breeding of animals, plants, fungi for the food, fiber, biofuel, medicinal plants and other products to use to sustain, enhance the human life. Agriculture was the key development in rise to the sedentary human civilization, whereas the farming is domesticated, species created for the food surpluses and that nurture the development of a civilization. The study of agriculture is known as the agriculture science. History of agriculture date back to thousands of years ago, and the development has been driven greatly different climate, culture and the technology. Industrial agriculture based on the large scale of monoculture farming has become dominant in agriculture methodology. The modern agronomy, plant breeder, agrochemicals such as pesticide, fertilizer technology are development have many cases sharply increases the yield cultivation, but at the same times they have caused the widespread of ecological damage and the negative human health effect. Selectively breeding, modern practices in animal husbandry have similarly increases the output meat, but raise the concern animals for the welfare of a human. It is also important, so that the agriculture, it is a very important. And the horticulture, that means cultivation crop like a fruit plant, vegetable plant, that is considered with a extra care, that is known as a horticulture. Horticulture, it is a science with the plant cultivation that include the processes preparing the soil, planting of seed, tuber, horticulturally usually referring the gardening in a smaller scale. The word horticulture derived from the Latin word hortus means garden and the cultus that means a cultivation. Horticulture is the branch of agriculture which deals with the art and science, technology and the business. The growing of plant include the cultivation, medicinal plants, fruits, vegetables, sprouts, mushroom, algae, flower, seaweed and the non-food crops such as the grasses, ornamental trees and the plants. Also include the conservation, landscape restoration, landscape and garden design, construction, maintenance and the arboriculture. Inside the agriculture, horticulture contrasts with the extensive field of farming as well as animal husbandry. The horticulturists apply their knowledge, skills and the technologies used to the grow intensively produce the plants for the human food and non-food uses for the personal and social need. Their work involves plant propagation, cultivation with the aim of improving the plant growth yield, quality, nutritional value and the number of uses can be done of a horticulture plant. Then fishery. Fishery is an important part of ocean, or the in the ocean fishes collection, their marketing and the cultivation are done by human, so that is a human also depends on the natural resource, that is a ocean. Generally fishery is an entity engaging raising or the harvesting of fish which are determined by some authority of to be fishery. According to FAO, the typically fishery is defined as in terms of people involved, the species or the type of species in area of water or the sieve method, fishing class, boats, purpose, the activity. Purpose the activity or the combination of their foreign features. The definition often include the combination of a fish or the fisher region, later finishing the fishing for the similar species with similar gear types. And the fishery involves the capturing wild fish or the raising the fish through a fish farming, or the directly or indirectly livelihood over more than the 500 people. Developing countries depends upon the fishery and the aquaculture. Overfishing include the taking a fish beyond the sustainable levels, is a reduce the fish stocks and the employment of many world regions. Then domesticated animals. I previously explained the domesticated plants. Same concept here are given, domesticated animals. Domestication has been defined as a sustained multi-generational mutualistic relationship which an organism consume the significant degree of influence over the reproduction care of another organism order to secure more predictable supply resource interest through which partner of organism gain advantages over the individual that remains the outside this relationship, thereby be benefited and offer increasing the fitness of both domesticators and the target of domestication. This definition is recognizes the both biological and the cultural component. Domesticated animals and the plants. All the past definition domestication have been included the relationship between the human with the plants animals, but their differences lay who consider that type of a definition and the relationship. Then uses of captivity and culture animals. Uses in captivity and culture animals. What is captivity culture or the culture animals? Captivity breeding is the process breeding of animal outside of their natural environment with a restricted constriction like farms, zoo and other closed facility. The choice of individual animal those that are the part of a captive breeding of population mating the partner within that population, that is known as a captive and the culture animals. Captive breeding is generally carried out one of these main purpose to produce animals at a commercial purpose, to produce animals for the zoos, aquaria, research institution and other public facility, increase the captive population and the number of threatened endangered species. In some case this individual is a part of management program aim eventually reintroducing these captive breed animals into the wild habitat population. In other cases captive facility claim to be the breeding of animals such purpose, but the animal may not be suitable or they are not a part of a legitimate conservation and the management programs. That is the main aim of a captive animal breeding. Then wild versus captivity. What is meant by wild and what is meant by captivity? What is meant by wild? Wild animals that are no interference of a human with their growth and development, but benefited to the human. That is known as a wild. And captivity, we have seen previously, captivity that means that is also wild type animal, but that the growth and development is controlled in a human hand. That may be collect from that animals or that plants from their natural environment to the artificial environment for the number of uses. In the wild animal, the host ever-changing environment, they spend their days covering the immense distance, searching for the food, raising and the protecting their young, interacting with the other for their own kind, protecting their territory and various other natural activities can be done that a wild by the wild plants or the animals. Captivity environment. Wild animals are forced to spend their days with the same predictable enclosures. They have a same daily routines. They are forced to live close contact with the humans, which are completely unnatural for them. Abnormal stereotypic behavior, such head hobbing हिट बॉम्बिंग, स्विमिंग, पैसिंग, बार बीटिंग, वेकुलाइजेशन आर ऑफन डेवलप कैपिटेटिव वाइल्ड एनिमल्स फॉर द कोपिंग मैकेनिज्म। दे स्टीरियोटिपिकल बिहेवियर्स आर डेवलप इन इन्वायरमेंट दैट डू नॉट प्रोवाइड एनिमल्स विद अ सेंस ऑफ अचीवमेंट और दे कीप अ एक्टिव। फर्दर मोर दिस बिहेवियर कैन बी कॉज बोर्डम, फ्रस्ट्रेशंस एंड डिप्रेशन। इन द वाइल्ड एनिमल डू नॉट डेवलप द स्टीरियोटिपिकल बिहेवियर्स। Stereotypical behaviors have only the been documented in the captive animals, human prisoners and them mentally disabled. Okay, this is about today's lectures. Unit number 2, biotic and the abiotic factors. Okay, if you have any doubts related to any points, please comment below the section and you have a need to the subscribe my channels. I share with your friends, family members and promote them for the subscribing. Thank you.